So Jason, what is density altitude?
Pressure altitude adjusted for temperature.
So what is pressure altitude?
Altitude above standard datum plane.
And what does that actually mean?
I don't know.
Well, let's fix that. Now, as pilots, we learn 5 different types of altitudes. Indicated, true, absolute altitudes, those are pretty straightforward. But pressure and density altitude, those tend to trip people up. Because, well, they're a bit more abstract. And if you don't understand what they mean, well, you could end up out of runway, out of performance, or plain just out of luck. So in this video, we're going to break down pressure and density altitude, how they're related, and why they matter for making safe pre-flight decisions. I'm Greg from Pilot Institute, the online ground school that makes aviation easy. Now, before you take off, you need to make sure that your aircraft has the performance it needs to complete the flight safely. Can you accelerate fast enough? Can you climb quickly enough? And can you stop soon enough at the end of the runway? That all depends on the air, not more specifically. Specifically, the air density. And you can't see it, but the air around us is like a fluid filled with molecules. And your airplane depends on having plenty of those molecules in order to fly. Now, if the air becomes less dense, meaning that the air molecules are more spread out, then your wing, your propeller, and your engine won't work as well. And here's why. Wings generate lift by accelerating the air and pushing it down. Now, in dense air, the wing has more molecules that it can work with so that you can get more lift. But in thinner air, fewer molecules means that there is less lift at the same airspeed. Now, propellers work in the same way. Dense air gives the propeller blade more to grab onto, producing more thrust. Now, in thin air, they're pretty much less effective. And engines, well, they rely on oxygen in the air in order to burn fuel. More density means more oxygen and therefore more power. In thinner air, power is going to drop off. So what exactly affects air density? Well, 2 of the biggest factors are pressure and temperature. Now, higher pressure squeezes air molecules closer together, making the air denser. Lower pressure, on the other hand, lets them spread out, making it thinner. So to figure out how dense the air is on any given day, we need to start by looking at pressure. And that brings us to pressure altitude. Now, you've probably heard before, just set your altimeter to 2992, and that's your pressure altitude. Okay, sure, but what does that actually mean? When we talk about pressure altitude, we're talking about how high you'd be in something that we call the International Standard Atmosphere. This is the imaginary version of Earth's atmosphere where everything behaves in a completely predictable way. Stick with me, not possible, but this is gonna help you understand. It's pretty much like a massive spreadsheet. Each row is a different altitude, and next to each of those is a matching pressure. Now, as you go up, pressure starts dropping, approximately 1 inch of mercury for every 1,000 feet. And that makes sense. The higher you climb, the less air there is above you, so there is less weight pushing down. And so, less pressure means less air density. But unlike the real world, in the standard atmosphere, that rate of change is always the same. 1 pressure for every altitude and 1 altitude for every pressure. So let's say that you measure the air pressure around your airplane, and let's say that it's 24.9 inches of mercury. If you look that up in the standard atmosphere table, you'd see that it matches with 5,000 feet. That's our pressure altitude. So far, so good? Now, earlier, Jason mentioned that pressure altitude is
altitude above standard datum plane.
That's just the level in the standard atmosphere where the pressure is exactly 29.92 inches of mercury. So pressure altitude is your height above the imaginary zero point, if you want to call it that. And as we'll see, that makes a very useful reference when it comes to performance. When the manufacturer creates the performance charts for your airplane, they base them on the standard atmosphere, not the actual real-world weather that we're flying in. That's why those charts use pressure altitude as a baseline. It gives everyone that same starting point, if you want. So before you can figure out how much runway you'll need and how quickly you can climb, you first need to find your pressure altitude. And there are 2 different ways that you can get it. First off, in the cockpit, you can just set the altimeter to 2992 and then read the altitude on the altimeter. If you're doing performance planning during pre-flight, you can also calculate it manually. Take the airport's elevation and then the current altimeter setting and then use this formula right here. Now let's do a quick example. Say that you're at an airport with a field elevation of 1,500 feet and the current altimeter setting is 2942 inches of mercury. First, subtract 2942 from 2992. Next, you're going to multiply that by 1,000. And then you're going to add the field elevation. So even though the airport's physical elevation is 1,500 feet above sea level, the lower than standard pressure outside is going to increase your pressure altitude to 2,000 feet. Now, pressure is not the only thing that is going to affect air density. Humidity plays a small role. Now, surprisingly, humid air is slightly less dense than dry air. The water vapor molecules are actually lighter than the nitrogen and the oxygen molecules that they replace. But humidity doesn't make that much of a difference. You know what does? Temperature does. When air gets warm, it expands. Think about a hot air balloon. Heat the air inside and it becomes less dense than the cooler air that's around it. That's what makes the balloon rise. But the hotter the air, the thinner it gets. And cold air does the opposite. It contracts and becomes denser. And this is why pressure altitude alone doesn't tell the whole story about aircraft performance. We need to bring in density altitude, which is basically the pressure altitude adjusted for non-standard temperature. But what makes temperature non-standard? Well, let's go back to the standard atmosphere table for a second. Each altitude doesn't just have a standard pressure. It also have a standard temperature and density. So if the outside temperature matches the standard temperature for your pressure altitude, your airplane will experience the standard air density that is listed in the table. But if it's warmer or colder, the air density will be different, thinner or denser than standard. And if you looked up that new temperature-corrected density in the standard atmosphere, it would line up with a different altitude. That's your density altitude right here, the altitude in the standard atmosphere where you'll find the same air density. So if pressure altitude tells you what altitude matches this pressure, then density altitude tells you what altitude matches this density. More importantly, it tells you what altitude your airplane feels like it's flying at. And it makes it a much better benchmark for performance than the actual pressure altitude alone. Now you're back at the airport with the 1,500-foot elevation, and it's a really hot day. The density altitude will be thousands of feet higher than what your altimeter reads, and that can seriously affect your takeoff and landing performance. First, your takeoff roll increases. You still need to hit that rotation speed, but with less engine power, you accelerate more slowly. That means that you'll use more runway. Next, climb performance drops. With less lift and less thrust, you won't climb as quickly, which can make it harder to clear obstacles after takeoff. And finally, landing distance increases. You'll fly the same indicated approach speed, but your true airspeed, the actual airspeed that you're flying through the air, will be higher. That means that your ground speed is higher as well, and you'll need more runway in order to stop. We call this high density altitude. Now, this can be confusing. High density altitude doesn't mean the air is dense. It means that the air is actually thin, like you'd find at a much higher altitude. The good news, it's not hard to avoid flying in high density altitude condition. Avoid flying in the heat of the day, for example. Keep your airplane as light as possible, and always check that you have enough runway and climb performance for the conditions. Now, you'll find that information in the performance charts of your POH. You don't need to calculate density altitude directly. Those charts are based on pressure altitude and temperature. So essentially, density altitude is already baked into the scenes. That said, knowing the density altitude can still be helpful. It gives you a quick way to get a feel for how the airplane is actually going to perform, especially when conditions are far from standard. Now, there are a few ways that you can find out, and the easiest way is by checking your EFB. Most of the apps are going to show density altitude in the METAR section. Now, during a warm summer day, the ATIS, or the Automated Weather Broadcast, may also report it. You can also use an E6B, an electronic flight computer, or a density altitude chart. And if you want to calculate it by hand, here's the formula. Now, let's talk about ISA temperatures for a second. ISA stands for International Standard Atmosphere. That's the model that we're using here. At sea level, the standard temperature is 15 degrees Celsius, and it decreases by about 2 degrees for every 1,000 feet of altitude. So at 5,000 feet, the ISA temperature is around 5 degrees Celsius. Now let's say that the actual outside temperature is 25 degrees Celsius, which happens at 5,000 feet elevation in the summer. That's 20 degrees above standard. Now multiply that by 120, and now you add that to the pressure altitude. So your density altitude here is 7,400 feet. Now that tells you that the airplane is going to perform as if it were at 7,400 feet, even though the altimeter says that you are at 5,000 feet. Now, that's not something that you need to calculate on every flight, but it's a good way to build awareness especially when you're flying in hot weather, at high elevation, or with a heavy airplane. Now, understanding the difference between pressure and density altitude isn't just for the check ride. It's actually something that every pilot needs to know. By the way, are you feeling stressed about your upcoming check ride? Well, our free private pilot study sheet can help calm your nerves. It covers the most important topics that you need to know for your check ride in a user-friendly format. This way, you can walk in feeling prepared and not stressed. Click below to download.